what have you seen, no, in terms of people claiming it, gano'n nila kabilis talaga nakukuha yung pera? Kasi yun din yung argument doon na pag insurance yun, pag kailangan mo, someone dies, a breadwinner dies, or malaking bills hospital, they can get it. How long is yung, at least average, across the board, different insurances?
Well, that they can if it's get an it? Old policy, you can get it as fast as one day.
Oh, talaga?
I mean, sometimes I've seen that. Personally,
all this what?
Like, the policy's been enforced for like 3, 4, 5. Kasi sa insurance, may tinatawag mong contestability period eh. Again, depende yan sa amount. Pag malaki amount kasi, di ba, they want to make sure na walang fraud, walang ganun involved. But for 1 million, 2 million, mabibilis yan lumabas. Unang-una, guys, I don't know, maybe I'll run contrary to what Marvin always teaches, no? Ang investments, hindi naman nilagay yan para maging mayamang-mayaman ka eh. Diba? At the end of the day, ikaw ang nagpapayaman sa sarili mo. It's what you do. Your ability, your greatest asset is yourself.
I'm turning 40 this year, and my question is this. There are people like me na 40 na mid-30s that have gotten a lot of insurance nung earlier years, or they got a semblance of insurance also. My question is this. Should they actually get more still?
That's a question depending on your need pa rin. Eh. Kasi kung yung, kunyari marami kang binili, kasi yung marami kang binili, that's relative eh. Diba? I mean, again, that's depending on your need. So, for instance, pwede isa lang anak mo, so okay na to 2 million. Pero, yung isa lang anak mo, pero, diba, I mean, gusto mo paaralin sa international school, gusto mo pa-abroad, then that's not gonna be enough. So, gano'ng karami rin ba yung assets mo? So, you have to do an honest to goodness financial planning eh. And for you to ascertain whether what you have is enough. Hmm. Dapat may needs-based ka talaga. I mean, I've been teaching a lot of people, you have to do computations, protection analysis to determine how much you think. So, kasi I may have 5 million, that's more than enough. Or I may have 20 million, that's yet not enough. So, everything is going to be relative depending on the need, depending on the situation, depending on what you have. Probably Marvin took a lot of insurances when he's young, but aside from that, he was able to build his asset base that he doesn't need to add.
May nabasa kasi ako Randall Chomson blog nung 2007 na ano, the best time to get insurance is when you're younger because the premiums are lower. Yun, mga kaya na pa, insurance mo.
Alam mo, bukod sa insurance, bukod sa bata ka pa, may factor din yung health. Like ako, when I was 40, 41, I was diagnosed with diabetes. From then on, hindi na ako nakabili ng insurance. Kasi, most insurance company, although today, hindi na ako diabetic. I'll tell you the secret. No? Hindi na ako diabetic. So maybe I can add. Pero,
talaga? Talaga mag-coke ka?
Coke zero. Hindi coke. Okay. Pero, technically, I'm not diabetic anymore. Pre-diabetic na ako.
Congrats. Okay na tayo.
And, you know, health issues are reversible.
Should they base it? Siyempre, tumatanda sila. Either they're earning more or their asset base are getting bigger. And then, siyempre, we don't have time to do like yung nitty-gritty na financial. Ano. Should they lean it more na eto na yung assets ko, kailangan ko banggain yun with more insurance, or eto na yung sweldo ko, eto na kinikita ko, eto mawawala sa pamilya ko, I should actually get more.
I think if anything happens to you, how long will they survive with the money that you have? Mm. With an asset, di ba? And, or also another way, yung assets na yan, gusto mo bang i-liquidate nila? Let's say marami kang property binili. Gusto mo bang i-liquidate yan? Kung ayaw mo i-liquidate yan, gusto mo talagang manahin nila ang buo, then you have to add insurances. Parang hindi ma-liquidate yung assets mo. Again, at the end of the day, it's a need based eh. And the only way to do that to sit down with a good financial advisor na well trained, na graduate ng Randall Johnson masterclass para they know how to do it right. Kasi estudyante rin ni Marvin yon pag masterclass sila.
Question on that also, no, connected to that. There might be a lot of people that have gotten VUL already. If they would get another insurance, say premium amount na kukunin nila, should they get more VULs, or since may VUL na sila, should they just get term? How would you go about that mix also?
Babalik pa rin tayo sa needs based, no? Kasi ano ba concern mo? If you just want pure protection, then don't get VUL, get term.
You mentioned that kung gusto nilang maging active na mag-invest versus yung VUL, pero they can still also be passive without doing VUL na mag-index fund sila or go straight
yeah
to mutual funds and equity funds also eh. So is that the main parang differentiator if they already have VUL or
what? At the end of the day, Marvin, it's more or less, no, it's gonna be the same if you do it that way. So at the end of the day, convenience na lang yan. Di yun na, I mean, kasi mayroong advantages at disadvantages din yan. Kasi kung di DIY mo yan, I buy term, then I can just invest in the market myself or do a more passive indexes. Mayroong mga pros and cons yan. For instance, what if something happens to you? Diba? Yung investments mo, kaya naging iniwan, will now form part of your estate. Yung VUL investments mo, while you're alive, it's an investment. But upon your death, it automatically becomes an insurance proceeds. Now, that can be insignificant for some people, but it can be significant for some people. Diba? I mean, merong advantages yan. It automatically transfers to whoever you want to transfer. Whereas again, if it's an investment, you have to go to estate taxation and planning. So, may mga pros and cons yan. So, it's more convenient for a risk protection to put it in the VUL rather than do it in DIY. Alam mo, Marvin, I've done some simulations. Some are more efficient. Some VULs are better than the others. They're not all the same. So, depende na yan anong VUL na product na binili mo, saan ka bumili, kailan mo binili, and so forth and so on. At the end of the day, it's just preference. Preference. Like ako, I have term, but I have VUL. Diba? I have active, well, not so much active investment anymore. I still have a lot of my fund. Kasi tawag nila yung BTID na buy term, invest the difference. They buy the term, but they don't actually invest. So, as in, sa VUL, parang, kasi ano yan, imputed yan, no? May sisingin sa'yo, may karo kang babayar, pag nabayaran, mag-alap. So, may pros and cons yan. A lot of people will put so much emphasis on this is better. What better is something that works for you?
Sabi mo, pag nasa insurance, something happens, pati yung fund, they could claim it as part of the insurance. You've been very, very long in the insurance industry na talaga. What have you seen, no, in terms of people claiming it? Gano'n nila kabilis talaga na kukuha yung pera? Kasi yun din yung argument doon na pag insurance yun, pag kailangan mo, someone dies, a breadwinner dies, or malaking bills hospital, they can get it. How long is yung, at least average, across a board different insurance?
Well, that they can if it's get? An old policy, you can get it as fast as one day.
Oh, talaga?
I've seen that, unfortunately. Like, the policy's been enforced for like 3, 4, 5. Kasi sa insurance, may tinatawag mo contestability period eh. Again, depende yan sa amount. Pag malaki amount kasi, diba, they wanna make sure na walang fraud, walang ganun involved. But for mga 1 million, 2 million, mabibilis yan lumabas.
So pag malaki ba, they don't release na, oh, kuha ka muna konti para at least magamit ng family mo?
Or meron mga ganun situation, they do partial release. Minsan, ang fault nandun sa nagpa-file ng claim eh. Diba? Hindi kompleto yung gang, diba? I mean, minsan yung death certificate, hindi pa na, diba, they expect to be paid, hindi pa naman kompleto yung requirements. Yung mga requirements yan. And then, of course, the insurance company should also investigate. No? Kasi sa insurance, meron tinatawag mong ano eh, may tinatawag mong contestability time. At saka also, din ina-ascertain yan kung meron ba yung fraud. Kung meron ba yung ano, diba? Kasi, nagsabi ba na totoo yan? Baka mamaya, meron pa lang cancer yan. Hindi sinabi. So, they will, you know, they have some, they'll do some investigation. So, pag malaki amount, it takes a longer time kasi mas madami naman.
I have a curious question. Is it considered fraud yon na kunyari, someone passes away, namatay siya asthma, tapos hindi niya tinik yung box na may asthma, pero nagka-asthma pala siya nung 10 years old siya. Will that nullify the proceeds that they could get?
Relative yan kasi at the end of the day, any misstatement, misrepresentation, or grave, nasa insurance company yan kung magbabayad o hindi. Kasi kung may knowledge ka na may asthma ka, may knowledge ka na diabetes kaya hindi mo dineclare, then ikaw nag-commit ka ng ano, ng no, parang grave misstatement and or misrepresentation. So then eventually, there's, kumbaga, the law will side with the insurance company pagdating sa ganyan. But then, that's a qualified statement. How grave is it? Kailangan na-approve din yan, ha, Marvin. There's diagnosis, there's medical records, yung mga ganun bagay para makita mo yan. So generally, yes. If I want to talk about the letter of the law, but many insurance companies, pag luma na yung policy, they just pay the claim.
Got it. Last question for insurance.
At depende sa amount. Pag malaki amount, of course, pag maliit amount, sa totoo lang, most of them, it's just too much work for them. They just pay the claim. Wait na naman sila sa markets.
Okay. So, last question for insurance. May statement lagi na, you can never have enough insurance.
That's not true.
Is that true or parang, how much is enough?
You know, I've done a lot of protection analysis, though, that I teach that. And there have been clients that I approach or, you know, persons that I approach that actually, lumabas na they don't need it. So, kasi kunyari, marami ng asset base, may enough liquidity, may enough insurance, and some people, they don't need it. So, hindi totoo yung point, di ba? Pero, kunyari, may extra money ka, gusto mo dagdagan yung iwan sa anak mo, then maybe you can do that. So,
got it. Okay.
Like, oh, like, do I still need more insurance? Although, I don't think I can buy insurance anymore, but I maybe would choose to buy it if I want to, you know, now I want to leave something to my grandkids. So maybe I can use insurance because I'm only paying a fraction of it.